नमस्ते, आई एम भावना वर्मा फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ यूनिवर्सिटी एंड फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट कंप्यूटर साइंस। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क एंड द नेम ऑफ माय सिस्टम इज डाटा लिंक लेयर प्रोटोकॉल। सो आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट माय सेशन अबाउट द डाटा लिंक लेयर प्रोटोकॉल। देयर आर डाटा लिंक लेयर इज वन ऑफ द सेवन OSI मॉडल रेफरेंस लेयर। तो सो डाटा लिंक लेयर फंक्शनैलिटी बेसिकली स्प्लिट्स इनटू टू सब लेयर्स, दैट इज अपर सब लेयर व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड लॉजिक लिंक कंट्रोल LLC एंड सेकंड वन इज लोअर सब लेयर व्हिच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड मीडिया एक्सेस कंट्रोल और MAC। ओके, देन LLC इज रिस्पांसिबल फॉर हैंडलिंग मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग एंड डीमल्टीप्लेक्सिंग एंड लिंक सर्विसेज like reliability and flow control. MAC is responsible for framing and media access control for broadcast media. So now I'm going to discuss deeply with logic link control. Okay. Logic link control multiplexes the protocol running at the top of the data link layer. It provides flow control, acknowledgement and error notification. Flow control means whenever there is a difference between the capacity for sender and receiver to send and receive the data with different speed, then we need to control the flow between the sender and receiver so that the amount of data that is transferred is received by the receiver. Acknowledgement is used whether the data is received by the receiver or not. Error notification, if there is error is come when we send the data, then an error notification came. Third functionality is it provides addressing and control of data link. So addressing is also done in the data link layer. Another functionality is it specifies the mechanism that are used for addressing stations over the transmission medium. Means when data is sent from one station to other station, then addressing is needed so that data can identify where to go. Another functionality is it controls the data exchange between the originator and recipient machines. Means between sender and receiver, the control of the data is the control over the data is managed or also managed by the logic. Now second sub layer is media access control. It determines who is allowed to access the media at any one time. Means when we send data from one sender to other stations, then who can access the media if the media is common for all the stations to send and receive the data. Means it refers to the frame structure delivered based on MAC address inside. It also determines where one frame starts and other frames end. It means frame synchronization is done by the media access control. Another is there are four main types of frame synchronization. That frame synchronization can be based on four types. That are time based, character based, counting based, character counting based, byte stuffing and bit stuffing. Now I'm going to discuss what are the different data link protocols. So first data link control protocol is SDLC, which is also called synchronous data link protocol. What is the functionality of SDLC? It is used to connect remote devices to mainframe computers. It ascertains that data units arrive correctly and write flow from one network to the next. So SDLC assures that one data is correctly flow from one network point to another network point. Now the next one is HDLC, means high level data link control. So it is also based on SDLC, but it provides both reliable and unreliable services. It is bit-oriented protocol. It means it works on bits. Also, it is applicable for both point-to-point and multi-point communication. Now next one is Serial Line Interface Protocol, that is SLIP. So it is used for transmitting data inputs, data units between internet service provider and home user over a dial-up link. Dial-up link is basically the channel over which the data is sent. It does not provide error detection and error correction facilities. Fourth one is point-to-point protocol. It is also called PPP. Okay. It is used to transmit multi-protocol data between two directly connected computers. It is byte-oriented protocol, which is widely used in broadband communications having heavy loads and high speed. So its functionality is that it is used for broadband communication, which have high loads and high speed. Fifth one is link control protocol. It is also a PPP protocol, but responsible for establishing, configuring, testing, maintaining, and terminating links for transmission. It also negotiates for setting up options. Sixth one is Network Control Protocol, NCP. These protocols use for negotiating the parameters and facilities for the network layer. For every higher layer protocol supported by PPP, one NCP is there. So that's all about today's session, where we discuss about different data link control protocols. Thank you.